Joburg Spring Fillies and Mares Challenge, they all said, let's crash open. And they racing, and Desert Miracle wasn't too smartly away. Takes her medicine, hum, she races at the back of the field.
Humdinger wanna cling, 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 cling. Cling a clinger when we ling, 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 ling. Ling a linger every time we kiss goodnight. You're a hum, hum, hum. Humdinger, how my heartstrings zing, zing. Zinga, zinga, how I ting, 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 ting. Ting-a-linger when you hug and squeeze me tight.
Get there in the closing stages. Humdinger won. Humdinger beats Desert Miracle. Give Me a Shot was third, and then came Mercury Rising.
Mike, not easy to get trainers to chat to you between Christmas and New Year, so thank you very much for your time. Follow the Flow represents some rather influential owners and a rather ordinary debut, but there must be a bit of hope somewhere.
Yeah, poor debut. She's very well bred. She was quite weak at the time. It was a sales race. We took a chance. I'm expecting her to run a lot better than that. I think she's going to need a little further. Definitely strengthened up and working a lot better than she did first up. But I mean, she's got to make a 20-length improvement.
Okay, well, that's good to hear. Then Equestrian Affair represents Lady Laidlaw's colours.
He's been gelded, and his gelding didn't go great, so he took a long time to get over it. He's over it now. He seems a better, more settled, chilled horse. I'm expecting the run to improve him. He's got a place, a conceivable place chance for sure.
Okay, then Humdinger, after a very impressive hat trick, I think we can just draw a line straight through her run in the Charity Mile.
Yeah, sure. It was always going to be stretching her slightly, being a mile at Turfantine in the soft, because she's quite an aggressive racer. She's had a nice rest since then, done really well. She's quite handicapped here. Well, the fillies are in these plate races fairly well handicapped with their allowance. She's got a good draw, very, very fresh. Going to come on with a run, but I'm expecting her to be competitive.
The previous race, she showed a lot of courage. I think she beat a stable companion who just ran out of gas.
Yes, and that was on top in the winter, which are conditions I think she would prefer. I'm not convinced she likes it. Too soft.
Okay, Arrivedicia ran a very, very good race behind a highly thought of individual last time out, and he had no luck in the Graham Beck. What are you expecting from him?
He's a horse I've always thought a fair bit of. He's got a hell of a lot to find at the ratings. It's a small field, but quality field. He ran very well the other day, was doing his best work late. As I say, I've rated him, and I just think he's just taking a little bit of time to sort of, for the penny to drop, let's put it that way. He's better than his rating, for sure. It's going to be a tough race to win, there's no doubt. There's some high-rated horses here that are going to be very, very difficult. But, you know, given the conditions, no penalty for places, we take our chances.
I think one of those horses that might still be in your yard would be from the Nathan Cotson yard. He's a high-class individual.
Yes, and we're trying blinkers on him. He's in a good space. He's a nice horse. If the blinkers work, he should be right there.
Terrific. Then the much-vaunted work that you mentioned about Sea Anemone came to fruition last time out.
She didn't win as well as I thought she could win. It was only a second start, straight around a mile. You know, one couldn't be forgiven for her being a little bit at sea. Obviously, with the conditions here, given her rating, she can't get a penalty for running a place or running well. So we'll take our chances to see what we've got. She's a filly I really like. She's way better than her rating. And let's see. You know, she works like a filly that's 25 pounds better than her rating. But, I mean, she's only had two starts, so it's very hard to rate her correctly. This race will tell us if we have or haven't got something.
And then to put the lid on the day... Angel C, who's got smatterings of form and ran well last time out behind Stolen Thunder.
I thought she ran very well last time. I thought she got. I thought she could have been a lot closer. She got eased at a point where she should have been going forward, which cost her a lot of momentum. So I wouldn't leave her out of anything.
Sadly, Safe Passage will not be taking his place in the lineup on the King's Plate. But the fact of the matter is, you said that this horse that won the Guineas with such contempt now has a chance to prove that he's a horse that can beat South Africa's champion Marla in Jet Dark.
Oh yeah, look, we're looking forward to the race. It's sad that we haven't got a runner. Safe Passage has had a hiccup in his training in Cape Town, so that's him out for the season there. It would have been nice to participate in this event, but nevertheless, I'm looking forward to it more than anything because I was really surprised at what I saw on Guineas Day. You know, as I said, I hadn't seen a horse since Horse Chestnut win the Guineas like that, and he moves those legs so quickly. He reminds me of Messi, that horse. You know, he's just very athletic. But you know, we keep saying he's got to prove it. I think he has proved it,
I think so too.
And I'm hoping that. The King's Plate will be the cherry on the top, and we'll get to see the horse that this is. It's nice to have. I think there's a lot of public interest. I think it does racing an unbelievable amount of good, apart from the owners and the stable. Everybody, it just gives everything a positive vibe, having a real smart horse like this around. It's massive pressure on the trainer. I know, been there, done that. You don't sleep at night, and. It's hard, you know, you lay there thinking, have I done enough, have I done too much, what have I done, haven't I done, or, you know, it's not an easy, and there's always, of course, there's a million advisors out there, everyone knows a bit better than you, but I wish Candace and the family, and the Bass family really well with this horse, because I think this is, with a good positive vibe we've got in racing at the moment, this will be the cherry on the cake, hopefully.
Ring-a-ringer, will you marry me? Marry me.